Yo, what's good? What's good? It is week 35. Week 35. Y'all kind of far away right now, so I'm gonna try to keep my voice up. But my bad if it gets a little low. So, but yeah, it's a lot to talk about, or a lot that went down this week. I'm gonna start off by saying, my drawing is complete. That dragon is complete. Like, yo. And it's looking pretty good. I think the shading pulled it all together, but I'll get back to that. Yeah. So I started out the week. I ain't really get all my, you know, once again, I ain't get all my push-ups and pull-ups done. Because I started out the week on a heavy bag, trying to just practice my left. Practice my left crosses, my left hooks, and bro, I was going crazy, you know. Going crazy on that bag, man. Unfortunately, the speed bag is popped, and that's my fault. I was complaining about it not being full enough, and I went to go ask for them to put air in it. They ain't have no regular hand air pump, they use like a electric pump. Brought that mug in there, filled up the bag a little too much, and that mug popped. So we ain't got no speed bag no more. But yeah, went crazy on the heavy bag. So yeah, my arms was dead. My left tricep was over with for the majority of the week, but I was still trying. I got 500 push-ups in this week, and 225 pull-ups. So 500 out of 1500, and 225 out of 375. So again, look, I'm not gonna go as hard on the punching bag on Monday or tomorrow. That way I can try to get closer to my numbers, the numbers I'm supposed to be reaching. Cause like, dang, I should have been hit my 1500 push-ups and my 375 pull-ups, but I know I got it in me. So I don't know why I ain't hit it yet. But yeah, this weekend I've been really craving a gym. I just want to go to the gym. I'm ready to work my upper back and stuff again, shoulders. I'm neglecting my core right now because I want to do that last. Like, I do my core when I do cardio, but yeah, I'm like putting that stuff last. I'm trying to work on my arms and my back and all that. So, my shoulders need work for sure. They really need work. I'm gonna miss the speed bag because that was targeting my shoulders real well. Like for endurance and stuff. It's okay. I can do other stuff. I know some other workouts. But yeah, that dragon. That dragon, man. Dragon tail. Let me stop. Anyway, that dragon looking good. I mean, it look a little friendly in my opinion. Like, that mug. It look too friendly. It ain't no, like, vicious looking dragon. Like, it's looking all animated and all that. But I drew a dragon. I ain't drawn no dragon in years. I don't even remember the last time I drew a dragon. I usually sculpt dragons and I paint dragons. I painted a dragon's eye. I don't paint dragons. But yeah. As far as I can remember, this is my first time drawing a dragon. I've drawn the wings before on hearts. I've drawn those wings. But I think I've drawn dinosaurs before. But yeah, I think this was like my first time drawing a dragon. And this mug, I like it. I just finished it yesterday or last night. That mug came out clean. Came out real clean. Oh, she better get prepped for that tattoo, cause bro, she was trying to distract me, bro. She was trying to distract me. She was causing a lot of problems this week, bro. I got a question. It seems like there's a lot of misunderstanding about the term gaslighting. Like, I believe it's gaslighting when you make like an assumption or a statement, like inquiry, whatever you want to call it. Like, I think you're being this way, and then the person responds by repeating that as a question, exaggerated and like slow talking. Like, say, I think you're gaslighting me, and then they'd be like, gas, you think I'm gaslighting you? Like, you know, extra slow and exaggerated tone. Like, bro, like everything you saying is just bizarre and it's distracting. Like, it'll change the conversation's direction. Like, I feel like that's gaslighting for real. Like, repeating everything you say in a question, like you just shouldn't be asking that question. It's other ways, but that's like the main example. Like, that's gaslighting, ain't it? Like, I don't know. Comment if I'm wrong. If I'm right, I don't know. I believe that's gaslighting. Anyway. As I was saying. Oh yeah, that's that. Starting out the week, we were supposed to be working, doing work-based learning. We went up there, and like, we was ready and all. Like, I felt it was annoying to have to wake up way earlier than I usually do, but I felt pretty good by the time we got up there. We got up there and the supervisor told our instructor that their company hasn't signed the paperwork to approve work-based learning yet. So we haven't got to start this past week. So, it's all good. They talking about doing leisure time working now. They got these two bikes by the security office that I want to fix. Cause you know, that's what I do. That's my thing. I fix bikes. I convert bikes. That's my little, one of my hobbies. I love it. But I'm trying to fix those up cause I want to use one to go job search. Like, if I got to do another application and find a little part-time gig, then so be it. I just need some money. I gotta give me a whip. So, gotta get some bread in my pockets. What else we got? Working on that bike situation. Hey, Mr. Amron, the head person here, the top person, whatever. Like, I don't know what his title is. Center director, something like that. But I spoke to him about it. And he said those bikes don't belong to nobody. Like, they've been here for years. So I'm like, yeah, I got dibs on that red one. It's two of them. One of them, the red one, got like the disc brakes in the front and the back. I'm like, yeah, I got dibs on that one. So I'll fix both of them so that another person can use the bike too. But, I want first use on the red one. I call it. Yeah. Hoping to get that moving this week. Start working on that. In class, we was we're doing light gauge framing. Like, so we're right now we got like a mini office space that we're making. It's gonna have four different rooms in it. That mug looking real clean. We threw that up real quick, like about a week, less than a week. Took less than a week to get up. That's pretty cool. It was fun. I'm gonna show the video of that, and I did the most parts I did was the headers and the cripples for the doorways. That was fun, man. That was relaxing. It was good. Especially being gaslighted and pranked. I gotta get into that for another story. I ain't even gonna talk about that. But gaslighted and pranked by Shay, my son's mother. I really appreciated that we had a project this week, and it kept me from losing my mind. It was satisfying. So. I swear, I was about to not do the drawing and all of that. But yeah, we did that. I got the drawing done, did what I was supposed to do. We done pinky promise on the drawing, so I was gonna have to do that anyway. I was gonna make sure I did that anyway, even if the contest was done. But got distracted for a little bit. But yeah. One thing I noticed about this campus is that it's heavily favoring extroverts. Like, they do announcements on the Google Meets on Mondays, but it's like, and they go through those announcements real quick. Like, it just boom, boom, boom. They flip the slides real quick. But that's it. That's all we got for announcements. Anything else that goes on throughout the week that may have just been spontaneous or whatever is through word of mouth. If you don't know people, if you don't talk to people, you won't know that something's going down, like as an assembly, or like this past week they opened up the donation store to just let people get clothes for free. That's where I got my shirt. Y'all never seen me wear this shirt before. But yeah, I got this from that donation place, donation closet. Yeah, I got this one, and I got a bigger one just in case I wanted to tuck the shirt in. But yeah. You won't know unless you talk to people. Unless somebody else heard that somebody else heard that something's going down. Like, they favor the extroverts. I haven't decided whether that's a good thing or a bad thing, but I feel like it could be a good thing. Like, you gotta communicate. You gotta communicate. If you wanna be informed about anything, you gotta communicate with your peers and all of that. So. But yeah. Before I end this video, I want to say thank you again to my subscribers, my viewers, and my likers, all that, because we almost at 100. We almost at 100 subscribers. Shoot. She always was trying to joke around. She be saying, if I get 100 subscribers, I got to give everybody $100. I'm like, look, I am not balling. I'm not balling like that, like, no thank you. But I will do a giveaway. When I hit 100 subscribers, I'll do a giveaway. But I ain't gonna talk about it till I see that 100 piece. Then we'll talk about the giveaway. But yeah. Sir. You're almost there. 100 ain't the goal, but 100 is nice. Alright, I'm drifting off. I still gotta watch She-Hulk today, because I've been keeping up with him. I guess the season finale came out this past week, so I ain't seen what happened. I ain't seen what happened yet. But I'm gonna watch that today. Yeah. I will catch y'all on the flip side.
Yo.
Back again. I forgot to tell y'all. I don't know how I forgot, but We're gonna need y'all to vote on the drawings. I'm gonna post mine on my page. She gonna post hers on her page on IG. But I ain't gonna put her tag on here, but I'll put her tag on the post on IG. So if you wanna go vote for which drawing is better, I swear, do not let me get no neck tattoo, bro. But I'm gonna put it on my page. It's at @icetray_icetray. Yeah. I don't know how I forgot to tell y'all about that, but yeah. Yeah, go vote. Participate. Let me start. I never thought I'd hear myself telling y'all to go vote. But yeah, I'm gonna need them ballots to come in. Anyway, I'm gonna go put that out. We putting those out today, and then next week video, I'm gonna announce who won. But yeah, again, I will catch y'all on the flip side.
Serving food for the thought like it's rock to the fiends. I said this shit for years, but this life ain't what it seems. Saying that you can't just solidify, you never will. Say you would, say you could, but you ain't got the skill. You gotta climb the highest mountain to master the hill. You gotta climb over your ego to master your will. Give up on your dreams for a suit and a pension, goddamn. I hope y'all here for the intervention. You say you would if you had the money, don't make me mention it. Don't cost nothing but time for you to pay attention now. Don't get me wrong, I know there's people out there hating on you. And it feel like your self-esteem is breaking on you. All they ever seem to do is hate when you speak. They spend 7 days praying on a week. I know the world's sleeping on you like a sedative. Talk all you want about me, homie, I'ma let it live. Hate it is, hate it ass, say I sound repetitive. Hating in your blood, you was born to be negative. Never been. I struggle every day, but I just can't let the devil in. And if I knew back then what I know right now, never made it, and the people that persevered even though they was hated, that had a dream and a vision that they followed like a religion. But on the real, the road to success is prone to collision, and every now and then something happens that's unexpected, like that newborn in your life, cause you was fucking unprotected. And I swear nobody perfect, hell I know I ain't. Yeah, I know this verse is heaven sent, but I'm far from a saint. Living life with no complaints, trying to do just what I can, learn from my father's mistakes and become a better man. I plan to see them, watch them grow, teach them everything I know, show them how to fight his battles and always go toe to toe with this. I know cause I've been high, low, right, wrong, but I had to do it all just so I could write this song, huh? I spit knowledge like the listener is my only son, and grip the mic like I'm at war and it's my only gun. Sometimes this journey to the top can be a lonely one, yeah, and this victory lap a lonely run. While my hometown screaming, you the chosen one, telling myself don't choke, don't be the frozen one. I've been working like I've never been. I struggle every day, but I just can't let the devil in. And if I knew back then what I know right now, I've been working like I've never been. I struggle every day, but I just can't let the devil in. If I knew back then what I know right now, I'd be better than I've ever been.
Bobby, run it.